Namaskar. Hello, learners. You must be familiar with various classroom strategies that are used in elementary school teaching. But all these classroom strategies are relevant for monograde situation. But a teacher comes across situation where she has to teach a multigrade or a multi-level classroom also. So today we are going to talk about management of multigrade and multi-level teaching in this session. But what exactly is this multigrade situation? Well, when one teacher is teaching children of a single class at a time, that is called a monograde situation. But when a teacher is required to teach children of two or more classes simultaneously, it is referred to as a multigrade situation. And the teaching strategies adopted during this class are called multigrade teaching strategies. Now, multigrade situation is prevalent in India. It is also prevalent in many other developing countries across the world. And it is generally found in rural areas with low population and small number of students in a school. Why does this multigrade situation happen, or why does a multigrade situation arise? There are many reasons for it. Sure. The number of classrooms in a school are less than the actual requirement. Therefore, the shortage of classrooms in the schools results in a multigrade situation. The teacher recruitment policy is also responsible for the multigrade situation. Generally, for every 40 students in the school, one teacher is recruited. If there are 80 students in a school, then there will be two teachers in the school, irrespective of the fact that there are many other classes going on in the school. A number of schools are also located in the remote, rural or tribal areas of our country, and many teachers are not willing to serve in these schools. Therefore, this results in a multigrade situation. Absence of teachers due to prolonged illness or because of their engagement in other academic, non-academic activities also results in a multigrade situation. Then there are other reasons like running of special intervention programs, delay in teacher appointment, which might cause a multigrade situation to happen in our classrooms. This multigrade situation actually poses a lot of challenges for the teacher who is in the classroom. Students from different grades and abilities are there in one classroom, and therefore this increases the workload of the teacher. She not only has to teach the class, she has to prepare the work plans, she has to check children's notebooks, she has to prepare the TLMs, and all this causes a lot of challenges for the teacher. It is also difficult to make different lesson plans for different kind of students in different grades and with different learning abilities. It is difficult to provide individual attention to so many students in the classroom with different grades and abilities. It also becomes inconvenient for the teacher to conduct activities in one classroom for different grades. Generally, the prescribed textbooks and the prescribed curriculum are relevant for a monograde situation. But when a teacher finds herself in a multigrade situation, then the completion of the prescribed course is also difficult in the given time frame. Preparation of the timetable also requires intensive thinking on part of the teacher. So there are these various challenges which a teacher faces when she is in a multigrade situation. So what are the strategies which we can use to help us in having an effective classroom environment in a multigrade situation? Well, generally, a learner-centered approach is found to be most suitable and effective in a multigrade situation. And four effective strategies have been listed out, which are very useful for the teacher when she is teaching in a multigrade situation. These four effective strategies are classroom organization, grouping of students, provision of learning materials, and planning for learning situations. Now, let us deal with these one by one. When we talk about classroom organization, the most important component is the management of space. The available space has to be managed accordingly to create space for students' learning corner, for activity corner, for display of boards, for blackboards, and so on and so forth. But the important things to be kept in mind while managing the space in the classroom is that the students should sit comfortably without disturbing each other. There should be proper ventilation and light for every student to do their work properly. There should be adequate space for free movement of the teacher and the students. And the most important is that all the learning corners should be easily accessible to all the students in the classroom. The next important aspect of classroom organization is how to make the students sit in the classroom, that is the seating arrangement. Therefore, we talk about the kind of seating arrangement that should be available or should be made accessible to the students in a multi-grade situation. If we have a proper or an appropriate seating arrangement, it minimizes the distractions for the students and it creates an effective learning environment. But the seating arrangement is not fixed. It can vary from different classes depending on the teacher and the kind of activities she is getting done from the students. If we look at the picture, picture one, this seating arrangement, in the seating arrangement, you can see that the students are sitting in separate groups and facing the blackboard. The blackboard is in front and all students can see it. The teacher stands in front of each grade and teaches the students. Now, this kind of arrangement is good because the teacher can look at all the students, but it is not very good for the student interaction between the groups and amongst the groups. Now, look at this picture too. This shows another type of seating arrangement for students in multi-grade situation. There are two blackboards for two different grades of students, and the students of each class sit facing their own blackboards. The next picture, picture 3, is similar seating arrangement which accommodates three different classes. And if we look at picture 4 presents another type of seating arrangement where the students of three classes sit in a semicircle and facing the teacher and the blackboard. This arrangement is very good for common activities like telling a story, discussions, or creating various activities and material for the students. Now, these kinds of arrangements are not fixed. These arrangements, these sitting arrangements are only suggestive, and the teacher can make the children sit in different arrangements according to the activities she has planned for the day. The second important strategy is grouping of the students. When we place the students in groups, that is very good for the students' cooperation. They learn how to share, they learn how to interact with their peers, and there is a lot of peer learning happening in our classrooms if we make appropriate grouping of students. But the important points to keep in mind is that the teacher should always form small groups of 4 to 5 students, as interaction is more in these smaller groups vis-a-vis a larger group. There are various types of groups which can be formed as and when required according to the plan of the day. The students should be allowed to move from one group to another as per their interest and ability. Labeling of the slow students in any group should be avoided completely. Now, the teacher is an observer in the group activities and she should ensure that all the students participate in the group activities, and she needs to encourage that even the slow students in the class are also actively participating in these group activities. Now, the grouping in the class can be done in two different ways. There can be grade-based grouping and there can be ability-based grouping. We will talk about the grade-based grouping. When we group the students on the basis of the grade they study in, that is called the grade-based grouping. Now, this is based on the assumption that same age group of children make progress at the same pace. Some examples of grade-based grouping are shown. For example, there is one teacher and she is managing three different groups, grade 1, a group of grade 2 and 3, and a group of grade 4 and 5. In another example, you will see that in the same classroom, there are two teachers. And these two teachers are managing class 1, a group of class 2 and 3, and the second teacher is managing a group of class 4 and 5. Similarly, in the example 3, there are two teachers, wherein one teacher is totally handling class 1, and the other teacher is handling class 2, 3, and 4 and 5 in two different groups. Now, when we make these group-based groupings, we need to keep in mind two important things. Grade 1 should be kept separate so that younger children are given more attention. And adjacent grades should be combined. For example, the teacher should combine grade 2 and 3 rather than combining grade 2 and 4. Now we move on to ability-based grouping. This is another way of forming groups in our multigrade situation. When small groups are formed according to children's different abilities, it is referred to as ability-based grouping. The ability here refers to learning capacity of the children and the rate of learning of each student. This kind of grouping is irrespective of the grades the children are studying in. And ability groups can be different for different subjects. Ability-based groupings are also of two types. They can be of similar abilities, and children can be grouped according to the mixed abilities. In similar ability groups, the group is a homogeneous group where students have similar ability. For example, all the students will be of high ability, of average ability, and there will be a group which will be of low ability students. Now, the teacher needs to prepare separate lessons plans for each of these groups. The advantages of forming similar ability groups in a classroom are that students can study at their own pace. It is very effective for group subjects like mathematics and languages. Students cooperate more with each other in the group. This kind of grouping is appropriate for designing remedial lessons for slow learners. It has a certain disadvantage also. The students are stuck to one type of grouping, and the low achievers are labeled, and they tend to lose confidence and interest and motivation if they are stuck to one group for a long period of time. The second type of ability-based grouping is mixed ability groups. When students of different ability levels form one group, that is students of advanced ability, average ability, and low ability are in one group, it is called a mixed ability group. The mixed ability grouping is considered better than the similar ability grouping in managing the multi-grade situation effectively. The advantages of mixed ability groups are that there is no need to change groups for different subjects. Students of different ability discuss with each other. There is peer support to low achievers. It is also very good for project work and to handle different co-curricular activities in a multi-grade situation. The third effective strategy that we will talk today in handling a multi-grade situation is provision of teaching learning materials, or the TLMs. Now, if the teacher makes appropriate use of the TLMs, it will help her in effectively managing the teaching learning in different grades at a time. The TLMs keep all students meaningfully engaged and involved in the classroom activities. They also help students understand difficult concepts by providing concrete examples. They also attract students' attention towards the lesson plans. They facilitate group learning and self-learning. TLMs also help in stimulating discussions among groups. TLMs also help teacher to save his or her energy and reduce the fatigue. TLMs are also very helpful in multigrade teaching because they reduce the excessive talking by the teacher in a multigrade situation. Now we come to the fourth and the last classroom strategy, which is very effective in handling a multigrade situation, which is planning for the learning situation. Now, teacher has to undergo a lot of planning when she is handling a multigrade class. Which grades are to be included in the multigrade teaching class? She needs to plan and understand what type of grouping is needed to facilitate the multigrade teaching. She needs to prepare weekly or monthly scheme of lessons to decide which subjects will be taught in which group. The teacher also has to plan and see what is the proper seating arrangement of different grade students in the classroom. She has to prepare and collect required TLMs in the adequate number and keep them at the TLM corner. The teacher also has to prepare daily lesson plans. The teacher also has to form small groups as per the requirements of the lesson, to specify activities for introduction, practice, reinforcement, and evaluation. The teacher also has to determine the amount of time to be spent on each activity. The teacher also has to determine the teaching time for each group or each activity. Now we come to multi-level situation, which is a little different from the multi-grade situation that we have discussed earlier. A multi-level situation is observed when there is presence of different ability levels of students. For example, there are high ability students, average ability students, and low ability students in a class. And this classroom is therefore referred to as a multi-level situation. The multi-level situation is present in both monograde and multigrade situations, but it is more relevant for a monograde situation. In a monograde situation, students with different subject learning abilities are found in one classroom. Students with different competencies are found in a monograde situation. Students with different attitudes and interests are also found in one classroom in a multi-level situation. When handling a multi-level classroom, the teacher faces a number of issues. Generally, the planning in a classroom is done based on the average student. But in a multi-level classroom, the students of high and low ability are often neglected. Also, using common textbooks as the center of instruction causes problems for students with different learning styles and abilities. Other issues in a multi-level classroom are addressing the learning needs of the different level students of different grades simultaneously is a hard task for the teacher. Preparing appropriate teaching learning materials and other resource materials is also difficult for the teacher in a multi-level classroom. So what are the strategies that a teacher can use to handle or manage a multi-level situation? Individual students' needs are to be identified before imparting teaching learning in the class. All children, irrespective of levels, should be allowed to learn at their own pace. Allowing students liking and voluntary participation in the group is very important to handle a multi-level situation. No grouping should be imposed on students. Peer learning needs to be encouraged to facilitate individual learning. The time needed for effectively managing each level in the multi-level situation should be handled appropriately by the teacher. In the end, I would like to sum up with certain important points for multigrade and multi-level situation. The learning activities need to be planned by the teacher for all kinds of learners in the classroom. These include the high achievers, the medium achievers, and the slow achieving students. The lessons need to be planned by the teacher so that every child is involved in some learning activities during the day. There should be opportunities for children to learn from each other in the classroom in all the activities planned by the teacher. If a multi-grade, multi-level teacher is innovative in teaching, with knowledge of his or her task and proper planning and management skills, successful results can be achieved through this system. Therefore, we see that managing a multi-grade or a multi-level situation is challenging. But with the right preparation, teacher can ensure effective learning can happen in her class. But the teacher needs to be prepared. She needs to do a lot of preparation for a multi-grade situation. She needs to pay attention to the seating arrangement of children. What kind of seating is good for students while she is doing different activities? She needs to think about the seating arrangement of the students. She also needs to think on how to group the children. Will he or she group the students based on their grades, or will the students be grouped according to their different abilities in different subjects? She also needs to think, will she follow the same group for all activities, or the groups will be changed for different activities? The teacher also needs to prepare appropriate lesson plans for each group of students in the multi-grade situation. A very important aspect of effectively managing a multi-grade situation is to arrange the blackboards, the display boards, and the learning corners according to the activities that she is going to conduct in the classroom. It is very important to keep in mind the different grades and abilities of the students in the class when all these arrangements are being made by the teacher. It is very important to prepare appropriate and adequate TLMs for the multi-grade situation. One set of TLMs can be used with two or three grades simultaneously, depending on the teacher's planning and her creativity. For example, if you are managing children of grade 1, 2, and 3 in your classroom, you can keep a basket with different items like leaves, shells, spoons, pencils, soap bar, etc. in front of the children. Show these items to the children and then cover it with a cloth. The class 1 students can be asked to orally name the items in the basket. Class 2 students can be asked to write the names of these items while the class 3 students can be asked to discuss and write the uses of these items in the activity using the same TLMs. It is very important to know that in a multi-grade situation, children need to interact, and peer interaction should be encouraged at all levels by the teacher. Children learn a lot from each other, and peer interaction in a multi-grade situation can help low-achieving students when they interact with the high-achieving students and engage in different activities with them. I hope you enjoyed this session on management of multi-grade and multi-level situation in the classroom. Thank you.